In this section, we're going to create a tag to control the fill level of our tank, and we're going to animate the colors of our pump and valve objects using our pump on, pump fail, valve on, and valve fail tags for our red, green, and blue tags. We're going to simulate our process using the WinCC tag simulator so that we can test out our dynamics. So let's get started. First, we need to create an internal tag that is going to control the level of this tank, and we're going to hook it up directly to this fill level property, which determines what level the fill level object is. To do this, we'll go back to WinCC Explorer and open Tag Management. In Tag Management under Internal Tags, we'll go to our Color Tags group and just create a tag here. And we'll call it Mix Tank Level. And we'll just set it to be unsigned 16-bit value. Now, back in Graphics Designer, I will go to my fill level object's fill level property, right click under the dynamic column, choose tag, and there's my mix tank level that I created. I could also find it by browsing directly here, and I'll just click OK. Now, any value that's in this tag is going to be translated into a tank level. So let's use the WinCC tag simulator to see what that looks like. The WinCC tag simulator ships with WinCC and it can only be used with internal tags. So I've opened the WinCC tag simulator. It's usually found in the Siemens automation folder on your Windows 10 or Windows 7 OS. So I'll choose Edit, New Tag, and it will give me a tag browser, and I'll just find the tag that I want to simulate. It will automatically open the Properties tab, and we just choose a way to simulate. So I'll just do random between 45 and 98. The fill level only goes 0 to 100, so I don't really want to go above this. And then I'll just click Active. Then if I go back to my list of tags, I'll see the tag here. But notice that the start simulation is grayed out. WinCC needs to be in runtime for this to work. I will just save. And I will go to runtime on my main screen, and we have runtime up, and notice that there is nothing in the fill level. That's because the tag by default is zero. If I pull up my simulator, now we'll see that the start simulation is enabled, and it should start simulating that tag value based on the properties that we set. So we can see the level is going up and down. Next, let's go ahead and add the tags for our red pump, pump on, pump fail, and valve on to our simulator. And then we'll add the dynamics to change these objects' color based on the states of those tags. So we'll follow the same method that we did to add mix tank level. I'll do edit, new tag. We'll go to our red structure and we'll choose red pump on and just click OK. And then under random, we're just going to do 01 and choose active. So we can see it's already simulating. We'll repeat the procedure. New tag. We'll add our pump fail. Choose our simulation. And then we'll add the valve tags for red. So now you see we have all of our tags for our red system here, and they're all simulating. Next, we want to use dynamic dialogs to change the color. So we'll start with the pump. I'll highlight the pump, and the trick here is go find the property that you want to see change. So we want the pump to appear red if it's on, red is running, and green if it's off, green is safe. So under control properties, the property that controls the color of this pump is ForeColor, so that's where we go. We're going to right click on the dynamic column and choose dynamic dialog. So for dynamic dialog, it looks at an expression or formula, and then the output of whatever type the expression is going to set our property. So our expression in this case is just what is the value of our pump on or off tag. So we'll click the button, choose tag, and we will find red pump on and just click OK. Now, this can only have two states. It's either a 1 or a 0, so we'll choose Boolean. And then the result is going to configure itself for a Boolean expression. If it's yes, we said we wanted red. I'll double click, I'll choose red. And then for false, 0 is green. That's what we want. And I can just click OK. So the way that we read this is the ForeColor property, which is now bold, by the way, you can see that it's bold. The ForeColor property is being controlled by this dynamic, and it's looking at the tag, and based on the value of the tag, we are setting this property. So if we want to see what this looks like, we can save. And my runtime window is still up. I don't have to hit runtime. I can just bring this up. And all I have to do is leave the page and come back. And we can see that this pump is going to change color based on our simulator. So now we're going to configure the fail color, where we're going to make the pump flash yellow. And then we'll do the same thing for our valve. We'll go back to the pump. And looking at the properties, if we look at our blank mode, we're going to use shaded. So just to show you what that looks like, I'll just set it by default to shaded. And then there's a blank color. Right now it's set to blue. So if I save this, here's our runtime window, I have to refresh the page. But see how it's when fail is on, it's blinking between blue and whatever color the pump is. So what we want to do is only if the fail bit turns on, we want it to blink, and we want it to blink, the blink color to be yellow. So the way we do this is first we're just going to set our blink color to yellow. So I'll double click this and just choose yellow. And then for our blink mode, I'm going to set it back to no, but I will right click, do dynamic dialog on the blink mode. We're going to look at our red pump fail, and it's also going to be binary. So we'll choose Boolean. And if it is failing, then I can just double click here and say, go to the shaded mode, which is going to make it blink between whatever color it happens to be in the blink color. And if fail is a 0, meaning there's no failure, then it's just not going to flash. I'll save this. That's important. And you can see that we have our dynamic dialog here on blink mode. So if we go back to runtime and see what's happened, we have to refresh the page. So now we can see that when our fail's on, it's flashing yellow. So now we're going to do the same thing for our valve. So I'll choose the valve. We'll go ahead and set the blink color to yellow. On our blink mode, we'll choose our dynamic dialog. Our expression is going to be our valve fail, since we're doing our failure mode. It's going to be Boolean. And then if it is in fail, it's going to flash between yellow and whatever the background color is. And then we're going to do another dynamic dialog and basically set it up like we did the pump, except we're going to look at our valve. We'll choose Boolean. And if the valve is on, it will be red. If the valve is shut, it will be green. Now we'll want to save this, and then we can just go back to runtime and see what we have. Leave the page, come back to refresh, and we can see that both of these are working. Now we want to configure our green pump and valve and blue pump and valve to be hooked up to the appropriate tag so that they also have this animation. We could just repeat those steps, but there are some shortcuts that WinCC lets you do, namely search and replace of tags. So let's take a look at what that looks like. Back in Graphics Designer, I'm just going to delete my blue and green pump and valve. I'll use my shift key to select both the red pump and valve where we put our animations. And I'll just right click, duplicate these, move them down, and do that to blue as well. Now that we have them duplicated, they still have the red tags associated with the dynamic dialogs. So we need to change that. I'm going to select my green pump and green valve, right click, and choose Linking Tag Connections. It's going to show me all the tags that are on these various objects. I'm going to go to the Find and Replace. And since we named our tags appropriately, red, green, and blue, I can just see that I need to change out red for green. So I just say find red, replace with green. So I just choose select. It will find everything that meets this criteria. And then if I hit preview, you can see, okay, it's going to replace red.pumpfill with green.pumpfill and so forth and so on. That looks good. Now this is important. You have to hit replace. And then you'll notice that now everything here is pointing to green. If I click OK, if I just go back and look at the pump and open the dynamic dialog, you can see it has been replaced. And we're still using red for on, green for off, regardless of the color here. So everything matches up. So we'll do the same thing with blue. I will find red, replace with blue. That's what it looks like. Hit replace. And then all we have to do is hit save. And we have to update our simulator so that we are also simulating our green and blue tags. So let's do that. So I've used the same procedure to add my blue and green bits for my pump and my valve. And we really need to save this so we don't lose it. So I'm just going to choose save. It will automatically just save in my WinCC project as a .sim file in my project folder. So I just have to hit save once more and then we're good. We can recall this at any time. Going back to runtime, we can see that all our animation is working and so our dynamics are working.